I don't know if it happened to you as well, but something that I noticed last year is that I read a lot of articles that started like, mobile changed the world in 10 years. And I mean, it sounds fairly nice, right? 10 years, it's a round number. It's big enough to change the world, but it's not too big because, you know, it's about tech, so things go really fast. But when you think about it, mobile was there a while before that. For example, my first phone was a Nokia 3310, 3310, and I think that got launched around like 2000 or something. So I was secretly wondering, why did it take 10 years? And so some of them were talking about the launch of the iPhone, but I looked back at 10 years ago from now, and actually 10 years ago was the launch of the App Store, which I think is the very beginning of the mobile revolution. Because the launch of the App Store is the moment where mobile goes from being just a device to being a platform and being an ecosystem to which you can plug existing services, but also create new services so that users can do much more with their phone. So looking at now, you know, what's happening today, we have voice-enabled technology, artificial intelligence, machine learning, all these things have been around for a while already. And I think we can say that, you know, they've been a bit overhyped over the past 2 years or so. But the way we look at it from our perspective is that we only launched, you know, Google Home last year in August in France. And actually more than that, we only opened the Google Assistant as a developer platform 4 months ago in France. So at Google, we see this as the very beginning of the journey. And when it comes to this voice-led revolution, it's actually year zero, which is extremely exciting. So I'm Lionel, I'm part of the product marketing team that looks after the Google Assistant, and I'm sharing this talk with Peter, and I'm really happy to do that and honored to do that, who's a senior interaction designer at Google, also working on the Google Assistant. What we will try to do today is first take a look at what's happening now with this voice revolution. Second, we'll try to envision, welcome everyone, we'll try to envision what it can look like in the future. And finally, we'll think a little bit about what we can all start doing today, concretely, to prepare for it. Do I have a clicker? Is this? And right. Oh yeah, that was the first slide. So I'll start with the Google Assistant. I mean, the idea is that we'll try to give you broader perspectives, but I'll take the angle of the Google Assistant, obviously. So when we built the Google Assistant, we built it to be a conversation between you and Google to help you get things done in your world. It's not anymore about searching for information only, it's also about doing things. And the way we design it, I mean, I chose three main characteristics of the Google Assistant to share with you today that I think are relevant when it comes to voice-specific applications. The first one is that you can talk to it as you can talk to me. So when we looked at the search, the way people use Google search, we realized that over time, the way people were searching evolved drastically from being quite robotic queries, such as weather, Paris, tomorrow, which sounds a bit stressful, to being much more natural queries, such as, what's the weather going to be like tomorrow in Paris? Or is it going to rain tomorrow in Paris? To which I don't know if you need an assistant to answer. But basically, this is a trend that we were clearly noticing. And when we built the Google Assistant, we really made sure that it would understand you in a natural way and that it would actually get better at doing so. So today, what we can see is that 70% of the requests that are made to the Google Assistant are made in natural language, which shows that users are reacting in a positive way to this. The second characteristic that I wanted to highlight is that, yes, you can talk to it, and yes, it's about voice, otherwise we wouldn't be here, but you can also interact with it in many different ways. You can tap, type, and show. Very recently, the last one, which is extremely exciting, I think. So it is about voice, but I think on top of that, it's about how does voice integrate within a whole other set of mediums to interact with those assistants. And I think that's quite an important thing to have in mind. And it's the reason why it's like this is linked to the third characteristic I wanted to highlight, which is that this assistant is available across a whole range of devices. So I would like to stop on this one a bit more, because in the introduction, I was talking about, you know, mobile and mobile going from being a device to a platform. But at the end of the day, every applications that we built for mobile were quite mobile-centric at the end. With the assistant, the vision that we have for this platform is to be device agnostic. So the experience that you can build on the assistant and that we build on the assistant work not only on each devices, but work across devices. So that if you start doing something on one device and actually are moving to do something else elsewhere, you can actually follow up the conversation from one device to another, which I think is extremely exciting. And it's not something that we've seen before. So this is the sort of third point I wanted to highlight. Now, if we look forward, I think that if we want the Google Assistant to be useful to people, which is what we care about, and as a product marketing team, that's like number one on the list, it needs to be able to integrate the services that people already know, love, and use. So that's why we opened the Google Assistant to developers through Actions on Google, which is our developer platform. And today you can already start building for it. I don't have this slide anyway. I had picked an example that we built with Timeout, which is a city discovery partner that, you know, is one of the pioneering partners that I think are really exploring in depth what we can do with this platform. So they integrate across different surfaces, and I think they're a good example of, you know, very interesting experiments that we start seeing launching all over the region. Still looking forward, I think this is one principle which actually isn't exactly the way it should be said, but I think the spirit is here. I won't get told off, I hope. So the idea here is that when you have a new platform, there's a natural tendency to actually copy what you learned on other platforms and just push it on the new one. And I think one principle that we apply to ourselves when we think about, you know, product roadmap or innovations, and that I think everyone working on this ecosystem should apply to, you know, its own company, is to start with the user. So this is a new platform. This is a new way of interacting with technology. I think it is really important to leverage what you know about your user or about your customers, the expertise that you have in your own vertical and your own domain, and try to understand what would an assistive experience be? What would be an experience that truly brings value to my user or to my customers on this new platform? I think that's a principle to always start from. And so still looking forward, I think envisioning the scale of the opportunity is something quite exciting. If we imagine that, and that's the reality, by the end of this year, there will be up to 400 million devices with the assistant available on it. The scale of that is massive, and I think it's very exciting. Another thing that to be taken into consideration to look forward is that from April last year to now, the assistant now speaks 8 languages, and what we're going to see happening this year in 2018 is going to be happening at the same pace. So you can expect much more to come pretty soon. So in order to prepare for it, there's a lot of questions that any company can ask to make sure that, you know, you're ready to embrace this revolution. But one of them is really about how do you design for this new platform? And that's what Peter is now going to touch on. Thank you.